How would you like to be able to run Windows on your Mac? Just watch if I double click on the desktop icon here, and it launches this program called Virtualbox, which then is actually the home of my Windows machine that is running on my Mac. Then I enter in the password, just like I do on a regular Windows machine, and ta-da, it opens up a Windows machine. And from here, I can open up Excel. Create a file, do some stuff in it, close the file, save it, do whatever. Then when I'm done with the Windows machine, just come over here and shut it off, and it goes right back down to my desktop. The first step in this process is to get VirtualBox onto your Mac. It's free, and it can be found here at virtualbox.org/wiki/downloads. And then you go over here and find which machine you want to load it onto. And I want it on my Mac, so that's an OS X. So I click on this link here, and it allows me to download a disk image, and I install it locally onto my Mac. I've already done it, so I'm not going to do it again, but all you have to do is click OK and go through the installation process, and it'll put VirtualBox on your machine. So installing and getting VirtualBox onto your Mac is the easy part, and it's the cheapest part. The next step is to acquire a licensed version of Windows, and I've got Windows 8.1 64-bit ISO, so that's a disk image that's really like a DVD file. And then I also have the authorization key that allows me to install it. So I've got those just stored on my desktop here for later use when I need to build my virtual machine. Next step is to launch VirtualBox. And here you see the disk image or the Windows 7 machine that I showed you a minute ago. You won't have that one, but that corresponds to this icon over here on the desktop that I used as a shortcut to launch that Windows 7 machine. I'm going to create a Windows 8 machine, or actually a Windows 8.1 machine, and I'm going to call it Windows 8.1 Windows, and then this version down here needs to correspond to the file that you've downloaded or bought or acquired from Microsoft. So now I hit create. Next step is to determine how much of your Mac's memory you're going to devote to your Windows machine. As a rule of thumb, I'll put half. So my Mac has 4 gigabytes of RAM, and I'm going to devote 2 of that to my Windows machine. Next is to create a virtual hard drive now. I'm going to create a new one from scratch. The default is 25 gigabytes, so I have to make sure I have at least this much space on my Mac before I continue. So I'm going to set it to dynamically create it. And how big do I want it to be? I've got enough hard drive space on my Mac. I could make a 100 gigabyte Windows machine that would last me for years. But if you don't have that much space, you ought to make it at least 50 gigabytes or so. Windows itself, just the Windows program, will take up 8 or 9 gigabytes of that 50. So you have to leave yourself room to install some apps. Next step is just double click on this file here. Next, you have to tell it where the Windows file is. Now I've got it out here on my desktop. So I go over here to Windows, scroll down to that folder that contains my Windows install file, the ISO image. There it is. Just double click on it. And then hit start. Now the rest of this process will take a better part of an hour, but I've shortened up a lot of the steps and cut out a lot of the video, so this is going to happen fairly quickly for your benefit to fit it all into a YouTube-sized video. So I just go through the install routine that is pretty standard for Windows, enter in my Windows authorization key, accept the license terms, hit next. Now I want to do an install only. I don't want the upgrade, so I'm doing a fresh install. So I click there. Now next. Now I've shortened this. This takes about half hour or so. It says it might take a while. It just did. It just took half an hour. And your Windows machine will want to restart a couple times during this process, so just go ahead and let it. Getting things ready. Now we're into Windows, and it's going to want you to set it up a little bit, so give it your PC a name. I just call it Ken's Win 8.1 machine. I just use the express settings unless you want to get crazy and set it up the way you want. It'll go out and find the internet. Now, if you have an existing Windows machine, it'll want to copy all the settings from it, but you probably won't, so just set up this as a new PC instead. If you want to activate any of this OneDrive stuff, you can, but I wouldn't bother linking it up. Now we're about ready to launch the Windows machine. It's going to get a last few things. Taking care of a few things. There, we have our Windows machine up and running. Next step is to make it work a little better on our Mac. It's nice to be able to share files, like copy and paste files from your Mac desktop onto your Windows desktop. So enable this shared clipboard and the drag and drop to be bidirectional. And then the next thing is really pretty cool. It's really the last step of the install. Sharing folders between your Mac and your Windows machine. It won't let you do it until you've activated this last step here. Insert guest edition CD image. When you do that, your Windows machine actually notices that you've just created a drive in the Windows machine. So if you open up the File Explorer and drag down to this PC, you see this new D drive. Double click on it to install some more bells and whistles from VirtualBox for free. Step through this, hit next, next, install, let that happen. Might take a minute, might cause you to reboot. Let it go ahead. It'll restart. Now we're back in our Windows machine running. Enter in my password that's an artifact of my Microsoft Live account. Now, go back into shared folder settings, and what folders do you want to share from your Mac onto your Windows desktop? So I'm going to click Other, and I want all of my documents from my Mac to be viewable and savable into my Windows machine, and also for me to be able to store files from my Windows machine into my documents folder on my Mac. Click on that. Now I could do it again. I could create another drive to the Mac desktop if I want, but I don't really need to do that. One place is good enough. The rest will just confuse me. Hit cancel. Hit OK. Now, let's go ahead and test this thing out. I can actually open up Internet Explorer. I know you Mac users love Internet Explorer. And go to the Blackboard page and make that my home page within my Windows machine here. Now if I enter in my password, make it a little bigger, hit the login key. And now I'm in Blackboard in my Windows virtual machine running on my Mac. Now the last thing I'd like to show you is how to share files from one machine to another. But first I'm going to shut this machine down. Anytime you want to quit the Windows machine, this is how you do it. Please don't hit the red dot just to close the window like you do a lot of apps. It might leave your new Windows virtual machine in an unstable place. Now if I want to relaunch it, actually, let me create a shortcut to this Windows 8 machine down here and put it alias on the desktop. So now whenever I want to launch this Windows 8 machine, all I have to do is click on this handy dandy little icon here called Windows 8.1. That's the file that I called it. Double click on it and it will launch my Windows 8.1 virtual machine. Log in, ta-da, I'm back in. Now if I look at this PC, you see I got a C drive, I still have that D drive down there. Let's look at the C drive to see how much space I've got on it. So just doing a raw install of Windows took up 8, almost 9 gigabytes of my 50 gigabyte drive that I created. Now I can also see my documents folder that's actually on my Mac hard drive. So let's test this out. If I go out here and I want to just create a simple text file on my desktop, I'm going to launch Notepad. And type in some just test text that I want to try to save this file from my Windows virtual machine onto my Mac. So now I'll save it. I'm going to put it on my desktop here. Call it a Windows file. Close it. Now see, I've got that icon on my desktop. Now, if I scroll down here, there's my desktop, there's that Windows file, and I want to store it onto my Mac hard drive. So I just click and copy it over there, and then tell it where I want to copy it. And now I've created a copy of that file onto my Mac. I'll minimize my Windows machine. It's still running down in the tray there. But now if I open up my documents and scroll down here, and here's that Windows file that was created on my Windows machine. And there it is. I can do the same thing with Excel files or any file that I want to create on the Windows virtual machine and copy it onto my Mac. I'm done with that, so I can click and throw it away, empty the recycle bin. And that's really about it. Remember, whenever I want to shut down my Windows machine, this is how I do it. That's it for creating a Windows 8.1 virtual machine on your Mac. Thanks and have a great day.